Hi, this is Jeremy Marson from FitSmallBusiness.com. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a professional business website and business email address with your own domain for just $3.45 per month. You don't need any technical knowledge to set it up, and you'll have your website up and running in less than an hour. I'll be walking you through the process step by step using the hosting service Bluehost. I'll be creating my own website as an example, but I encourage you to follow along by clicking the link in the description of this video. On top of giving you a domain, 5 business email accounts, 50 gigabytes of storage, and unlimited bandwidth, Bluehost lets you create a WordPress website at no additional cost. WordPress is the number one content management system in the world. About a quarter of websites use it across the entire web. With WordPress, you can choose between thousands of themes and tens of thousands of plugins to make your website work for just about any purpose. If you have any questions throughout this video, leave a comment below and we'll be sure to respond. Also, if you find our guide helpful, be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more helpful guides. Okay, let's get started. If you haven't already, click the link in the description to reach Bluehost.com. The first step is to choose your hosting account. Most businesses can get by with a basic account. If you want more than 5 email accounts, however, or want to create more than one website, consider the Plus account instead. In the next step, you'll need to choose the domain for your new website and business email accounts. This is something you won't be able to change later, so be sure to choose carefully. To start, I'm going to enter the name of my business. Unfortunately, this was not available. Bluehost does give me a few suggestions, however, I don't want to use a domain that's not a .com. Instead, I'm going to try a slight variation, adding salon to the end of my domain. If you're having trouble choosing a name, be sure to check out our guide at fitsmallbusiness.com. Since this domain is available, I'm going to continue creating my account. At the top, I'll enter some basic account information. Further below, I'll choose my account plan. You'll notice that the best pricing, $3.45 per month, is reserved for a 36-month plan. While this may sound like a long commitment, keep in mind that Bluehost will give you a refund if you wish to cancel early or switch your plan, so you aren't locked into any long-term commitment. For my account, I'm going to skip these add-ons, except for domain privacy protection, which hides my email and home address from the domain registry. This just prevents any spam mail from potentially reaching my mailbox. Last but not least, enter your payment information and click Submit. You'll now be on the control panel of your new Bluehost account. To start, let's create your first email address. Scroll down to the Email tab and click Email Manager. Now select Create an Email Account Now. Enter the name for your first email account. Note that this will be @yourdomain.com. Enter a password, and when you're done, click Create and Finish at the bottom. You can repeat this same process for each email address you need to create. If you want to log into your new inbox, select a webmail client. I recommend Roundcube. Then click View Inbox. This will bring you to the login page for your new webmail account. You can also access this from the Bluehost homepage. You're now in the inbox. This is where you can send and receive emails using your new business email address. You can also connect your account to Gmail or Outlook. This way, you don't have to log into a new inbox. You can continue using your old one to send and receive messages. For instructions on how to set this up, check out our guide at fitsmallbusiness.com. Now back in Bluehost, we're going to start creating your website. Click on Home. Then scroll down to the Website tab. Click on the option that says Install WordPress. From here, we'll begin installing the WordPress content management system on your new domain. While this may sound complicated, it's actually very simple. It's also free. While there are a few paid options that include one-on-one setup help, this video guide should give you everything you need. The first step is to choose which domain you want to install WordPress onto. As part of this decision, you need to choose whether or not you want www in front of your domain. For me personally, I prefer the look of my domain without it. Note that if visitors type www.checkyourheadsalon.com, they'll still reach my website, and the same goes vice versa. Now I'm just going to enter a few quick details, like my website title and a password, so I don't have to use the one randomly generated by WordPress. Be sure to check the boxes below, then click Install. The installation can take a few minutes, so we're going to go ahead and speed things up. Once complete, you'll see a message at the top that reads, View Credentials Here. Click on this link. In the upper right corner, you'll notice a URL, username, and password. This is how you'll log into your new website, so make sure you remember this information. Click the URL, then enter your information. This will bring you to the dashboard of your new WordPress website. You can think of this as your main control panel. You can do things like add new website pages, or if you plan on blogging, add new posts. For now, however, we're going to head to Appearance, then Themes. This is where you choose a theme for your website, which we can think of as a website template. At the top, click Upload. Here, you can browse through over 2,000 free WordPress themes. Many are designed to suit particular industries, such as restaurants or real estate, or particular purposes, like blogging, e-commerce, education, and more. The theme we're going to use in this demo is called Brasserie. Though designed for restaurants, it works great for spas, salons, boutiques, photographers, event planners, artists, and just about anyone else who wants an elegant yet playful design. Brasserie is responsive, meaning the website will automatically shift to fit any sized window or device, including smartphones. It's also highly customizable compared to other free themes. Since a few steps in this guide will be specific to the Brasserie theme, I recommend using it as well. If you do choose to go with another one, most of the steps should apply. However, the customization menu in particular will be different. Brasserie is also the theme we used in our restaurant website guide. So if you want to view more restaurant-specific instructions, or just prefer a text walkthrough, be sure to check out that guide as well at fitsmallbusiness.com. Once you've decided which theme you'll be using, simply click Install and then Activate. Right away, we'll start customizing our themes to make it a better fit for our websites. On the left-hand toolbar, select Customize. This will bring you to the menu where you can personalize your theme with your own branding and formatting preferences. We're going to go through each option on the customization toolbar, starting with Site Identity. On this menu, enter your website name and tagline. On the next menu, you can upload a logo. It works best if you have something small, no more than 150 pixels tall and 250 wide. If you need help on this, there's a few options. A graphic designer on Fivrr can give you basic formatting and design help for as little as $5. If you're looking to create a new logo from scratch, we recommend 99 Designs, the service we used at Fit Small Business to create our own logo. For more information, check out these guides. We also link to a few high-rated graphic designers in the description of this video. Next, you can upload a header image. Just like a Facebook cover photo, this is a banner that will stretch across the top of each page on your website. You can upload any image that's at least 1700 pixels wide, and WordPress will ask you to crop it if need be. If you need help finding a photo, we link to a website in the description of this video where you can search for public domain photos. The header might seem a bit too large, but don't worry. We'll add a call to action over this later, so you aren't wasting any space. Also, keep in mind the header will grow and shrink as you resize your website window. Next, under Site Colors, you can change your header text color or your theme highlight color. The theme highlight color, most notably, will change the main menu bar on your website. I'm going to keep both of them as is. Under Typography, you can change the font and style of your text. You can preview the different options in the window to the right. Again, I'll be keeping mine as is. Next, under Top Bar Contact Details, enter your phone number and email address. In a moment, you'll see this displayed at the top of your website. Now click Social Media Settings. Again, enter any social media pages you use for your business. Once finished, you'll notice your social media icons appear at the top of your website, as well as the contact information you entered in the previous step. For now, you can ignore the rest of the customization options. We're going to go back to these after you create a few pages on your website. Click Save and Publish at the top, then X out of the menu. Now that you're back on the main WordPress menu, head over to Pages. This is where you'll create the main pages for your website, including your About page, services, products, and so on. Most themes will come with a sample page, but you can delete this by checking the box and clicking Move to Trash at the top, then Apply. To create your own page, head to the top and select Add New. Enter your page title at the top and add any text and images below. You can always go back and edit these later, so don't worry about getting everything perfect right away. Once you have something entered, click Publish. I'm going to jump ahead and create 4 more pages for my website. Services, stylists, products, and policies. Be sure to pay attention to the permalink, which is displayed just below your page title. You can edit this to change the URL of your page. For example, checkyourheadsalon.com/policies. Once you're complete, add one final page called Home. Assuming you've used the Brasserie theme, find the box to the right that says Page Attributes. Under Template, select Custom Home Page. Keep the text portion blank and click Publish. The reason we're doing this is so that you can add some unique interactive features to your home page once we head back to the customization menu. For now, click Pages. You should be able to see each of the pages you just created. Again, we'll head back here later to fill out the rest of the detail. For now, head back to Appearance and then click Customize. Scroll to the bottom and select Static Front Page. Switch the option from Your Latest Posts to A Static Page. Then, under Front Page, select the home page you created earlier. This will allow you to design a proper home page rather than the default setting of displaying your latest blog post. Now head back and find Home Page Settings. Here you can add and remove features to your homepage. I'm going to start with Promotion Bar. Remember when I said earlier you could place a call to action across your header image? This is how you do it. Enter a title, button text, and button URL. For my fake salon business, this will direct people to an appointment booking page. For your business, just think of whatever your main goal is for the website. Perhaps you want visitors to submit a contact form, to land on your e-commerce store, or to watch a video or download a white paper. Next, I'm going to set up feature text boxes. These are specially formatted boxes that highlight the main aspects of your business. Plus, each box can link to an external or internal page. For my business, I'm going to use this to share my specialties and help direct visitors to the right page. Now let's fast forward. It helps to choose images that are similarly sized, although they don't necessarily have to have the same exact proportions. Here's how featured boxes look when complete. Again, they'll only appear on my homepage. Now I'm going to head back to the homepage menu. Today's special is another option that lets you add 4 images further below that also link to pages of your choosing. I'm going to skip this option to keep my homepage simple. On that note, under Hide Show Elements, I'm going to hide everything except for my promo bar and featured boxes. This will make things much less cluttered. Remember to hide elements on your other pages as well, such as your About or Services page. Now let's head back two layers and select Menus. This is where you can create the main navigation bar at the top of your website. Click Add a Menu and give it a name. Now select Add Items and find the pages you created earlier. You can add them in any order you like. Once finished, select Primary Menu at the bottom. You should now see the menu appear at the top of your website. Keep in mind, my browser is zoomed in right now, which is why it looks more like a mobile website. I'll show you how it looks zoomed out later on. Now head back and select Widgets. At the very bottom of your homepage, and on the sidebar of your other pages, you can add additional tools known as widgets. These can be anything from a text box to a search bar, email newsletter signup, appointment calendar, and more. By default, WordPress includes just a few basic widgets, but you can add more by installing plugins. For my website, I'll be adding the following widgets. In the left column, I'll add a search bar. In the central column, I'll choose a text widget and list my store's location and hours. Be sure to check Automatically Add Paragraphs at the bottom. In the right column, I'm going to add another navigation menu. This way, visitors can find the right page even after they've scrolled to the bottom. With that, your homepage should be just about complete. Since I've been zoomed in to give you a better view of this tutorial, I'm now going to zoom out. This is how my website will look to an average visitor. Now I'll click Save and Publish, and then exit the customization menu. At this point, you can head back to your pages and start filling in more detail. In addition to text and images, you can also install plugins that add more functionality to your pages. One example is a Google Maps embed, which is great to show the location of your store or office. Another option is an email newsletter signup form if you plan on using email marketing. If you want to learn more about plugins, we provide instructions in the article version of this guide. If you're in real estate or property management, you can also check out our guide where we show you real estate specific plugins, like a property search tool. When you're ready to publish, simply click this button at the top of your screen. While previewing your website, keep in mind that as long as you're logged in, a toolbar will appear at the top. To get a better idea of how your website will look to the average visitor, either log out or open it in a private browsing tab. Here's my website in all its glory. That concludes our guide on creating a business website and email address with Bluehost. If you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comments section below and we'll respond as soon as possible. I also encourage you to check out the article version of this guide, where we further explore plugins and explain how to remove the branding at the bottom of your website. From there, you can check out more of our online marketing guides, including a walkthrough of how to use Bing and Google AdWords with coupons for free advertising credit. Last but not least, if you found this guide helpful, be sure to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.